Hey, how's it going, everyone? Talk to me, Gooseman here with another GitHub Codespaces tip that you can use to make your development life a little bit easier. So here we are in my string closed captioner Phoenix GitHub project, and I have this set up so that I can do development out of Codespaces. So typically when you're launching Codespaces, we can go into code, open in Codespaces, and either you will be asked to create a code space or open one that you've already created. And we have one already created. So you can open it this way and it would open up in a browser, preferably in a Chromium based browser is best. Firefox I found is a little wonky at times. But instead of opening it up here in the browser, I find the best interactions is through VS Code itself. And let's pop over to VS Code and try doing that. So here we are in VS Code and can open up our project by going into the Remote Explorer extension on VS Code. And I have GitHub Codespaces already selected. And here you can see your Codespaces that you have launched. So I have two Codespaces, one for String Closed Captioner Phoenix, one for the extension project. But what we want to do is work on the String Closed Captioner Phoenix. So let's go ahead and connect to that one. So once you click connect, it'll initialize a connection, get you all set up and build your project. If you haven't had it built yet, all that type of good stuff. But we already have started doing development in this project, so it's pretty quick to launch up. All right, so we're in our project. We're developing inside of GitHub Codespaces. So let's go in and go ahead and start the application. So I click start, and that should get our project up and running. I've already pre-compiled it, so it's pretty quick at running. And we officially have our application running on localhost. Now, this is one of the benefits of running your GitHub Codespaces through VS Code is that it will run through localhost. So let's go ahead and hop over there and take a look at that. So here is the application running on localhost. If you were running the project through the browser, you would get a unique URL unique to your project, which makes it a little bit challenging if you were gonna try to do development that required OAuth authentication and trying to set the redirect URIs. Doing it locally is best for that. All right, so here's our project, and I wanna test out going to the announcements page. Oh man, when we hit the announcements page, we get an argument error. So what is going on? So it looks like we're getting an error when we're trying to construct a URL to do a request to the Notion API that I use to display information, and it's missing an API key. Ooh, that is not good. We are missing an environment variable, and typically, if you were going to try to go and fix this, you would probably go into your project and try to add in a .env file and put in your credentials in here. So like, you know, put super secret in here and try to get that to be, you know, in there. But then you run the risk of accidentally committing that. You have to, if you have to save this .env file somewhere, and let's say you, for whatever reason, had to rebuild the entire code spaces, the .env file will get thrown away because it has to rebuild the whole thing. It's only gonna reinitialize the project based off of what's been committed to the repository. Well, there's another easier way to do that, and that is to actually set your secrets directly on GitHub itself. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. So let's go visit our GitHub repository again. If we go to settings, and if we scroll down to secrets, we'll click on that, and we have secret in here, and There is one under actions for code spaces. So I click on that and you can create secrets, environment variables for your project so that when your GitHub Codespaces is launched, you have the secrets there already. You don't have to worry about setting up .env files. It's always there every time you set up the Codespaces. No one has access to them, only you and anyone that has direct permissions to run your GitHub Codespaces. So you can see right here, I already have some stuff set up for our secrets. So we need to set up the secrets for our Notion API. So we're missing two different keys. We need the API secret. So we would have to go into here and we have to set up the Notion client. And then we would also do the same thing for Notion for secret. And we would put our super secret in here. So that's how we would do that. And I'm going to set that up right now, but I'm going to do that off screen. So just put the name of the environment variable and the value and then add secret and you're all set up. Let me just take a moment and put in this stuff. All right. So now I've created both the required secrets that I need, Notion API and the Notion version. So you can see we've just updated now and updated 10 seconds ago. So now we need to check if this actually worked for our code spaces. We have the credentials that we need. So let's pop over back into VS Code to check that out. Now over here in VS Code, we have everything running. What I found, what you need to do in order to reinitialize the environment variables is, since it's already running, it doesn't have access to those environment variables yet. It's going to error out. So the thing that I recommend to do is go ahead and just stop your current code space. Don't close the connection, but you should stop your code space. So let's go ahead and stop it and wait a moment for it to deactivate, shut down, and we will attempt to start it up. All right, so our code space has officially shut down. We know that because there's no special little indicator here that it says that it's running. Usually there's a little icon in here, and usually there's a little option here to a little stop button here to tell it to stop. So let's go ahead and reconnect to that. So this should start it up all over again. And let's see if we have our environment variable set up so we can actually load that page and continue. All right, our code space has officially finished restarting, reinitialized, and let's try getting our application up and running again and get localhost running. All right, everything is up and running. We got our little dialogue here saying that it's running on port 4000. Now let's hop over to the browser and test things out. All right, so we have the application up and running again. Stringles captioner, here we go, looking all good. Localhost 4000. Now let's try visiting the announcements page once again. And hey, no error is showing up. We have the environment variables we need in order to get this page up and running and continue our development. So the quick tip for today is don't worry about setting your environment variables with a .env or somehow passing it through when you are running a command. Instead, what you can do is go into your repository, into settings, into secrets, and go into code spaces, and you can set all your environment variables there to use. So you have token secrets, like for me, I got a couple very important secret keys to set in order to get my application up and running so I can continue my development regardless of where I'm at, regardless if I delete the code space and restart it again. These environment variables are always here, always ready to go, so I can keep on doing what I can do best, and that is to just code. So hopefully you enjoy this video, and catch you in the next one.